We're here at ITU Telecom World 2012 in Dubai, and I'm very pleased to be joined by Mr. Tareq Al Awadhi, who's Executive Director for Spectrum Affairs for the Telecommunication Regulatory Authority of the UAE. Mr. Al Awadhi, thank you very much indeed for being with us today.
It's my pleasure. Thank you very much.
It's very nice to see you again.
Thank you very much.
I wanted to start off by talking about the incredible transformation of the ICT sector and what for you, you think are the principal opportunities arising from this.
Well, first of all, let me say that the telecom sector is a very important sector in the world, in any countries, if not the most sector, important sector. As always, we are saying everywhere now, especially that we are coming to the preparation of World Conference on International Telecommunication. And here, always we are saying and putting that the ICT sector is the most important sector in any countries, because all other sectors depending on that ICT sector, by providing the network, telecom network, making convergence, connecting everybody to each other, government services, public, all thing that is connected to the ICT sector. So it's be required that to have very excellent and developed with new technologies providing in any countries. The telecom world also, IT telecom world, which now coming to the end by today, is shows very exciting things happening here by seeing leadership, ministerial roundtables, young innovators. Those all let that this ICT sector is becoming very important sector in anybody. We saw so many things here in this telecom sector, telecom world this time, and hopefully that can let the telecom sector to be developed more and more in future.
What do you see as the major challenges for the ICT sector at the moment?
Most of the time that if I can't speak on my expert as in spectrum, because spectrum it is very important, essential issues for any operators that's starting in any country. Not only a commercial operator, even now we can say for the government entities. We had one session here in the telecom world, even this time, spectrum challenges. So yes, spectrum is very important challenges for telecom sector. New technologies now is coming, new ideas, but all of them that it depends on the spectrum. If we talk about a little bit about LTE or 4G, I know many countries still, they didn't develop the 3G network, where they will develop the 4G. And that because of the resources, which is the spectrum, is not available. So. Spectrum challenges is very is the most challenge in the telecom sector, as from my angle seeing that one. Hopefully that with this new things happen in last WRC 700 megahertz, that maybe solve some countries to develop their network, especially in Africa and Arab countries where they were behind to having 700 megahertz. So yes, and I say again that the spectrum is the most challenge in the telecom sectors.
What's the UAE's vision or response to addressing the incredible opportunities that are going to be arising from the ICT sector?
Well, UAE, let's say first of all, UAE, they have very developed network infrastructure, as everybody has seen it here. We have two operators who are providing very nice sectors. However, also they are looking for new technologies. But also that UAE is looking to improve other telecom sectors in different countries. We have one of the operators who's having their services in different countries, and they are doing very well. Also, UAE as a regulator, from my side, that I can say that we are providing our services to other telecom operators or other telecom regulators in different countries, especially those countries who started their liberalization or something like that, to improve their network by providing consultancy services, providing some policies, regulation, which to be suited to their countries. My philosophy is that every time I say that, don't copy the regulation as it is from different country. No. We'll teach you how to develop this regulation, these policies that they may suit your country. Depends on your economies, your GDP, your policies, your laws, your people, and those are things it has to be taken into consideration in order to develop this kind of policies. I can give you an example here of UAE. when we started, you know, that starting the regulation in 2004 when the TRA has been established. And when it comes to the deregulation we developed, we haven't take copy-paste of this regulation of different countries, no. We work inside, within the in-house, and we work very hard with our operators, with our government entities, with our people also, and developed, for example, for the spectrum, 22 regulations suit for the UAE, country. This may not suit for the different countries or our neighboring countries. We have discussed with them. Somehow it is maybe some of this regulation may be suit for them, some others not. So UAE is really looking for forward always, helping others in developing their telecom sector or IC sector in their countries.
It makes a lot of sense. And finally, I'd like to ask you, in terms of where we are at the moment, we're here at ITU Telecom World 2012. You've got a the United Arab Emirates has got a great presence here. Why is an event such as this important to you?
Good questions. Recently, I was telling to everybody a history how we have started here in the telecom sector. Our telecom sector or IC sector in the UAE is very developed, as I mentioned. But I'm going to talk a little bit about the history outside the UAE participation in this. And UAE has joined the ITU in 1972 when established, because UAE has been established in 1971. So 1972 has joined the ITU and the other UN, nation. UAE were participating in ITU a lot since that time. But active participation started in 1997. By submitting one paper during WRC 97. And then in 2000, we submitted seven paper, which was in Istanbul. In 2003, we were there with was booming of UAE, where we submitted around 40 contribution Arab common proposal, which already been developed in the UAE, submitted to GCC countries, and then to the Arab group, where they later submitted. From here, UAE was started that time booming by leading the Arab countries, by hosting number of meetings, number of issues, and later on we come up at this year 2012, where UAE chaired one of the important conference, the WRC, at the beginning of the year, and now hosting three major events, starting with the Telecom World, and then with World Telecommunication Standardization Assembly 2012 and World Conference on International Telecommunication. Okay, why it is important? Our leadership here in the country, His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed, the President of UAE, and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, the Vice President of UAE, they were having, their vision is very far away, that UAE to be, the UAE name to be enhanced and worldwide, and to be number one. Last year, or even before, UAE government, the president, has approved very important strategic plan for the UAE, which we call it 2021. And it has number of pillars, number of points. And one of the points that has been mentioned there, which is 2.3, enhance UAE image worldwide. And as we are TRA, Telecommunication Regulatory Authority, responsible for the telecommunication and ICT sector in the UAE, it is our obligation and our job to make sure that ICT of UAE to be enhanced in the worldwide and to be number one, which is, this is our job. And with all thanks to ITU, Dr. Hamad Touré, the Secretary General of ITU, and with all his support, we have reached to this 2012, where Dr. Hamidoun has declared that UAE Dubai ICT capital in 2012, this year, which is, this is our proud that we can see it. The close relationship between ITU and UAE TRA, it's really incredible. And we hope that this relationship let the ICT sector in the UAE, in the Arab countries, and the worldwide to be enhanced. We are supporting all the countries. We have a good relationship let's say, excellent relationship also with all members in the world. We are happy that to help them in ICT sector as well.
Well, we're very pleased to have been here, and I think the whole event has been an incredible success. So thank you very much for your playing your part in that. And I'd like to thank you very much for your participation in this interview today. Tareq Al Awadhi, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you very much. And just one more thing, if I allow me that to say, I would like to wish all the best also for our friends, Thailand, to host the next year this Telecom Award 2013 in Bangkok, and wish them all the successful, all the best. And we are also happy to help them in any kind of thing that they want from us to supporting and hosting this kind of thing. Thank you very much for having me this interview.
Thank you.
Thank you.